Not my precious creatine! Multiple people have asked me to address the rumors, the rumblings of creatine's link to cancer and linking this recent study showing an association of creatine and cancer risk. Since creatine, a molecule produced by your body and heavily supplemented for physical performance and sports, is linked to so many positive health and performance outcomes, it might be shocking to suddenly hear a link to cancer. I was surprised, since creatine and I go way back. I mean, we even barbecued together and watched a few games together. What a betrayal. Fortunately, that's not the case here, as we'll soon see. Creatine acts through a few mechanisms, but the first and foremost is the effect that it has on your cellular energy stores. More specifically, it enhances our phosphocreatine system, a concentration of molecules that hold on to phosphates to donate to spent energy molecules in the cell and regenerate them. This system bolsters our cell's ability to replenish energy stores. There's much more to it than that, but we can't get dragged into all the cool things that creatine does. The point being, this molecule, creatine, is implicated in improved physical performance, mental performance, and has thousands of studies behind it. In this recent study, the researchers analyzed data collected from over 25,000 people over 11 years in a retrospective manner. Meaning, they analyzed the data after the data was collected, not with an established question in mind to answer. They separated people by age and their creatine intake and assessed cancer incidence based on if people had ever been told they had cancer by a physician. If we put the creatine aside for a minute and look at the age data, the vertical axis is greater cancer incidence, and the horizontal axis is the four buckets of age in ascending order. So the first bucket is people 20 to 36, second is 37 to 51, and third is 52 to 65, and the fourth bucket is 66 to 80 years old. Plainly, these data clearly indicate that we shouldn't get older because it's associated with greater cancer incidence. So, don't get older. That's the first takeaway. Very helpful, I know. Superman, Wolverine, and Thor laugh in immortal. Done. What's next? In fact, if we look at the incremental increase in risk of age has on cancer, remember, the more to the right, the older, we can see a stepwise increase in cancer risk with older age. In the age bracket of 66 and older, the fourth bucket there, the risk is around 18 times greater than when we're in our 20s and 30s. Now, for context, I realize that number is pretty high, but if your risk is already low, something like, I don't know, 0.1%, which is not uncommon for people in their 20s, your risk in that fourth age bracket would still be less than 2%. Still a huge increase, but a little less foreboding than 18 times greater risk. Anyway, the researchers did the same bucket strategy for creatine consumption. The fourth bucket there is no longer the older age, but the greatest creatine consumption. The higher the bar, the greater the cancer incidence still. Like I alluded to at the beginning, the greatest creatine consumption was associated with cancer risk, but the association is inverse, meaning more creatine, less cancer. What's interesting here is that this seems only to be the case at the greatest intakes. I should also add, because we're looking at associations, the researchers performed some adjustments to the data to control for a number of factors, including age, sex, weight, blood pressure, exercise, and more. I'll put a list on the screen. If we zoom into quartile 4, only focusing in on the amounts deemed associated with reduced cancer incidence, there's a dose response curve based on intake. That dotted 1.0 line on the vertical axis indicates normal cancer risk. And if the red line goes down, there's reduced risk. Clearly, that's the case, confirming the previous data. But these data indicate that greater consumed levels reduce risk more and more. Pretty sweet. But there's some extremely important nuances to be addressed, because as much as I'd like to sing the praises of creatine, there's some nuances to be understood, like ever here on Physionic. Before we get to that, there's an extended version of this video that you're watching. It includes data on if weight makes a difference in these results and if creatine shows special benefits based on age. If you're interested, check out the full version of the video along with all my study analyses in the Physionic Insiders, linked in the description box. To the nuances. First, the researchers assessed creatine intake solely on meat consumption. Second, and this is a major problem in associative studies, trying to isolate single molecules as the causative variable for reduced cancer risk. Sure, you're controlling for all these variables like weight, exercise, and so on, and that's great, but it doesn't control for any number of other molecules or factors that correlate with creatine. The same isn't true when looking at larger effectors like meat as a whole, or exercise as a whole, or sleep as a whole, because you're not concerned about all the molecules and changes of a big effector like that. And you can control for other big effectors. Unfortunately, when looking at a single molecule, there's any number of other molecules that could also change that can't be accounted for. The specificity of the analysis unfortunately opens it up to significant confounding, something the researchers acknowledge too. Oh, and one more thing. Notice that they didn't account for total meat consumption, nor did they account for energy intake. These are further confounding factors. So, what's the point here? This still tells us that creatine associates with reduced cancer risk, starting at higher study concentrations, around 200 to 250 milligrams per day, which are low real-world concentrations. However, while I'd love to blindly defend my beloved creatine, this association is less protected from confounding, so other factors driving the real effect, than other associative studies, making this encouraging data, but we shouldn't make any strong conclusions on these data alone. But heck, there's plenty of evidence that creatine's amazing benefits, like those explained in these linked videos.